Hey there, just a small question. Have you been ignoring your violin warm-up lately? Let's be honest, there's nothing that we violinists like to skip more than our warm-ups. Like our scales. Our bowing exercises. Everything in between. But let me tell you something. One of the best ways to improve at violin playing is by doing your warm-ups before every practice session. Seriously, did I just hear you thinking that you don't have a warm-up yet? I am going to show you the most effective exercises to improve all aspects of your playing. If you are a beginner, you will highly benefit from this warm-up and notice your overall skills on all songs will improve. But wait a second, before you continue this video, you need to get your violin so we can practice the exercises right away and you will already have your warm-up done for today. Still didn't get your violin yet? Really, got it. You're not going to learn the violin without it. Okay, let's get started with part one of our warm-up. The first part of our warm-up is scales. Some violinists hate to practice scales. I used to hate them myself. Until I realized scales are one of the most effective ways to learn good intonation, which means that you will play beautifully in tune in every song. Doesn't that sound like a dream? Yeah! Then come on, practice your scales with me right now. The scales I recommend for absolute beginners are the scale of D, G, C and A. And I'm going to show you one of my favorite scales for beginners, which is the A scale. Get your violin right now and I will show you what the A scale looks like. First, start by playing your open A string. Then, play the first finger on your A string. Then, play a second finger, a high one. And then, a three. As you see, while I practice my scales, I keep all my fingers on the string. So I play 1, 2, 3, and all the fingers are on the string afterwards. Now let's move to the E string. Play E1, E2, E3. Did it just work out? Then let's go back. You always have to play your scales backwards too, because then you learn how to play backwards, of course. Let's start on E3. Put all your fingers in the right position. Make sure to first place all your fingers on the E string, so you don't have to search for them afterwards anymore. And play 3. Lift the 3. Lift the 2. Lift the 1. Put all the fingers on the A string. Play 3. Play 2. Play 1, play 0. So start by playing at least one scale before you start your practice. And be very precise. Make sure to correct every single mistake you made in your scale. So maybe your scale would look more like this. Just like that, and go on like that. If you are a little bit more advanced and this skill gets easy to you, make sure to add your fourth finger instead of the open string. So instead of the open E, you play an A4. Or instead of an open A, you play the D4. Like this. Like this. Thank you. after you practiced your skills, we go to the second part of our warm-up, which is long notes on all strings. This helps you to learn to how to divide the bow weight, but also to bow parallel to the bridge, because this is really important in order to create a beautiful sound on the violin. You can practice this the best in front of a mirror, so you can check if you're actually bowing straight, because if you're looking at it from this angle, you won't be able to see if you're bowing straight. And if you're doing so, don't forget to tell yourself you're looking good today. Practicing using your full bow looks like this. Make sure to practice it at every string. And if you get bored, of course, you can also add your skill to using your full bow. A little side note, don't practice your long bows with the skills at the same time if you're not able to play your skills in tune yet, because that will just distract you from actually learning to play in tune. Let's move to part 3 of our warm-up, which is practicing slurs. If you're playing a slur, it means you're playing two notes on just one bow stroke, like this. You can practice your slurs by adding them to one of your skills you practiced before. When you're practicing slurs, make sure that you switch from the first note to the second note exactly in the middle of the bow, like over here. Play the first note on the first half of the bow and the second note on the second half. If you get confused where the middle of the bow is when you're practicing, just add a sticker to the middle of the bow so you will remember where to switch notes. I'm proud you made it so far, because we are ready at the fourth and last exercise of our beginner warm-up. In this exercise, we are practicing string crossings and we are preparing for double stops, which are really cool if you don't know them yet and look like this. The exercise looks like this, and before I get started, make sure to never touch two strings at the same time, just if you want to do it. First, play only the G string and never let the D string ring. Then play only the D string. Only A. Only E. Only D. Only A. Only G. Only E. And don't let the other strings ring in between. Now play E and A at the same time. Make sure that this sounds evenly, so not like this, but really even. Maybe that will take a while and some practice. Then play A and D. And then play D and G. Of course, stick with the ones that are hardest. So, for instance, if you have a lot of trouble with G and D, practice them for a little longer. Until they sound more even. These were the four exercises that I found to be super effective for beginner violinists. Are you going to add them in your practice routine? If so, please tell me in the comments. Also, please give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. If this was your first time visiting this channel, welcome to the club! And if you want to get more videos and lessons on how to play the violin beautifully, please subscribe below and click on the little bell notification button so you won't miss any other violin tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and let's get back to practice right now.